Hello there, my name is Stephanie Rojo. I'm an estate planning and estate administration attorney at Stone Law Offices in Northwest Las Vegas. And one of the things I see a lot of times is someone will pass away and they own a safe deposit box in their name. And nobody knows what's inside that safe deposit box. Nobody really knows how to get into it. So that's usually when I am meeting the surviving spouse, or I'm meeting the trustee of the trust or the personal representative under the will. And that person is coming to me saying, we know there's a box, but the bank won't let us get in. So what do we do? What can we do? What are our options? Well, unfortunately, the bank isn't just going to let you go into that box, even if your name is listed as the nominated personal representative or trustee under the documents. You are actually going to need a court order to allow you to get into the box to inventory the items, because that box is owned in the person's individual name. So that's where I come in. I am able to open a special administration to get you an order appointing you as the authorized individual to go into the box, and also indicating to the banks that you have authority to get into that box. So if you're hearing this and you have your own safe deposit box, you might be thinking, well, how can I avoid that for my family members, for my spouse, for my personal representative or trustee? Well, the answer is quite simple. You should absolutely go to the bank and see if you can retitle that box into the name of your trust, or list the trust as the beneficiary of that box, or if there is another person that you could list as a joint owner or a joint accessor of the box, you would want to go ahead and take care of that. And I'll tell you why. Because it can be fairly costly to get an order to allow you to go into the box. So if I could share with you the best trick or tip to save your family money after you have passed away, the one thing would be, you know, if we could avoid probate altogether, it would be great. But the fastest and shortest way to avoid an issue with that safe deposit box is to retitle the box during your lifetime. Because unfortunately, I have seen cases where we've gone through all of the work to get into the box and there is just paperwork in there, or there is something that is worth nominal value, so it doesn't actually make it worthwhile to get into the box. But because there is a box, we can't just ignore it. We have to address it. You know, it costs time and energy and effort and funds to get into that box. So go ahead and retitle your box if you can. Otherwise, if there's nothing in your box and you were already intending to close it, you may also want to consider getting that box closed. I know a lot of times banks do offer safe deposit boxes as a bonus, or you've reached this level of advantage plan with us. Here, we'd like to give you the safe deposit box. But I'll really emphasize that there is a hidden cost to those safe deposit boxes if they're not titled properly. If you have any questions about your safe deposit box, about your estate plan, or getting into a safe deposit box for someone who has recently passed away, go ahead and give me a call. Stephanie Rojo from Stone Law Offices, and my number is 702-998-0444.